Please kneel. Please stand. Remember the basis of God, and with eternal protection sanctify yourselves, for whom Christ your Son, by the shedding of his blood, is published to the paschal mysteries, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Though through his suffering, my servant shall justify many,
and their guilt he shall bear. Therefore, I will give him his portion among the great, and he shall divide the spoils with mighty. Because he surrendered himself to death, he was counted among the wicked. And he shall take away the sins of many, and win pardon for their offenses. The word of the Lord.
One who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. So let us confidently approach the throne of grace to receive mercy and to find grace for timely help. In the days when Christ was in the flesh, he offered prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverence. Son though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered. And when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. The word of the Lord.
You are not one of his disciples, are you?
Peter was also standing there keeping warm. The high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and about his doctrine. Jesus answered them.
I have spoken publicly to the world. I have always spoken in the synagogue, or in the temple area, where all the Jews gather. And in secret, I have said nothing. Why ask me? Ask those that heard what I said to them. They know what I said.
When he had said this, one of the temple guards standing there struck Jesus and said,
Is this the way you answer the high priest?
Jesus answered him,
If I have spoken wrongly, testify to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me?
Then Annas sent him down to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing there keeping warm, and they said to him,
You are not one of his disciples, are you?
He denied it and said,
I am not.
One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of the one whose ear Peter had cut off, said,
Did I see you in the garden with him?
Again, Peter denied it, and immediately the cock crowed.
Out
where wearing the crown of thorns and the purple cloak. And Pilate said to them,
"Behold, the man."
When the chief priests and the guards saw him, they cried out,
"Crucify him! Crucify him!"
Pilate said to them,
"Thinking yourselves and crucify him, I find no guilt in him."
The Jews answered,
"We have a law, and according to that law, he owes God, because he made himself the Son of God."
Now, when Pilate heard this statement, he became even more afraid, and went back into the praetorium and said to Jesus,
"Where are you from?"
Jesus did not answer him. So Pilate said to him,
"Do you not speak to me? Do you not know that I have power to release you, and I have power to crucify you?"
Jesus answered him,
"You will have no power over me if it had not been given to you from above. For this reason, the one who handed me over to you has greater sin."
Consequently, Pilate tried to release him, but the Jews cried out,
"If you release him, you are not a friend of Caesar. Everyone who makes himself a king opposes Caesar."
When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus out and seated him on the judge's bench in the place called Stone Pavement, in Hebrew, Gabbatha. It was preparation day for Passover, and it was about noon. And he said to the Jews,
"Behold, your king."
They cried out,
Take him away, crucify him.
Pilate said to them,
"Shall I crucify your king?"
The chief priests answered,
"We have no king but Caesar."
Then he handed him over to them to be crucified.
It is finished.
And bowing his head, in order that the bodies might not remain on the cross on the Sabbath. For the Sabbath day of that week was a solemn one. The Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and that they be taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first, and then of the other one who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately blood and water flowed out. An eyewitness has testified, and his testimony is true. He knows that he is speaking the truth, so that you also may come to believe. For this happened so that the scripture passage might be fulfilled. Not a bone of it will be broken. And again another passage. They will look upon him whom they have pierced. After this, Joseph of Arimathea, secretly a disciple of Jesus for fear of the Jews, asked Pilate if he could remove the body of Jesus. And Pilate permitted it. So he came and took his body. Nicodemus, the one who had first come to him at night, also came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, weighing about 100 pounds. They took the body of Jesus and bound it with burial cloths, along with the spices according to the Jewish burial custom. In the place where they had been crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden a new tomb, in which no one had yet been buried. So they laid Jesus there because of the Jewish preparation day, for the tomb was close by. The Gospel of the Lord.
Fellow people of God, the significance of today cannot be overemphasized, because the cross of Christ is the door to heaven. It is the key to paradise. The cross of Christ is the downfall of the devil, and it is the consolation of mankind. The cross of Christ means so much for each and every one of us that St. Paul will say in his letter to the Galatians in chapter 6:14 that let none of us boast except on the cross of Christ. That is our inspiration. That is our pride. Identification with the cross of Christ is how we find meaning in different sufferings and crosses that we carry in our lives. Some people carry the cross of old age. Some people carry the cross of sicknesses. Some people carry the cross of poverty. Some people carry the cross of bad behavior when they have invested so much time, talent, and resources. Still, they don't see the result. Some people carry the cross of betrayal, different circumstances, different crosses. There are a lot of people who want to be here for this celebration, but they are not able. So each and every one of us, we carry different crosses. Some people carry the cross of injustice. Some people carry the cross and result of faithlessness. It is only in the cross of Christ that we find meaning for different situations. For the cross of Christ is the safeguard of our faith. Remember that St. Paul would tell us there are three things at last: faith, hope, and charity. In the faith of Christ, our faith is safeguarded. It is the assurance of our hope. The significance of today is still rich. And in the cross of Christ itself, we find the throne of love. As Father said yesterday, that the love that we receive from Christ in the establishment of the sacrament and the priesthood is so huge that to understand the whole meaning of the sacrifice of Christ will be too much for us. Christ has been going to Passover, but the one before he died was the last one. It was his last one. is to die for all of our sins. And each and every one of us, we remember that Christ offered himself. He is the Lamb without blemish to God for the fulfillment of the new covenant, which was promised in the book of Jeremiah 31:34. And the book of Hebrews reminds us that Christ is the fulfillment of that promise. So in the celebration of the sacrament of today, may we learn to follow Jesus in the way of his cross by the light that we live, to identify with him, to find meaning in our personal sufferings and pain by identifying the pains and the sacrifices of Christ. He is our hope. He is our confidence. He is our pride. May we never suffer in vain, for through the pains and the sufferings and the crosses we carry each day, may we be purified for entrance into God's kingdom. ministers, that by the gift of your grace, all men serve you faithfully. We make our prayer through Christ.
Descendants, Normally would for communion in two orderly lines, pew by pew. you haven't done so with your own hand sanitizer, we invite you to sanitize your hands with your sanitizer before you arrive at the cross. When you arrive at the cross, each line alternates approaching the cross to touch it. Additionally, we invite you to approach the cross having removed your shoes and leaving them in the pew. This is to be an act of humility as we come before the instrument of our redemption. After the veneration of the cross, the Blessed Sacrament will be brought in from the tabernacle for distribution of communion.
Thank you.
Savior's command and come by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Before the Lamb of God, before He protects away the sins of the world, happy are those who are called to the Supper of the Lamb. be given. Only faith in Christ and the everlasting redemption. Let us save you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.